Hi, can you tell us your name and what course you teach?
My name is Ian Waitz, and I teach Unified Engineering.
Can you tell us a bit about the class?
It's a large class that's put together by several different faculty members. We've taught it this way for about 25 or 30 years.
In which department?
In aeronautics and astronautics. And it provides education in several of the important disciplines for aerospace engineering, or aeronautics and astronautics. Structures, fluids, propulsion, thermodynamics, computers and programming, signals and systems engineering. And those are all taught in an integrated way over a year-long period, and it's two semesters with two subjects per semester. So it's the equivalent of four subjects put together in one.
And how many students take this, and what year are they?
It is the entry-level subject or set of subjects for our department. So all students who come into our department take it, and they all take it as sophomores primarily. And this year we have about 75 students in it.
And I understand there's sort of a team approach to teaching the class. Can you describe how that was worked out?
Yes, it's evolved over time, but we're each allotted a certain number of lectures, of the total number of lectures, and for each lecture there is a homework that goes with that. And those lectures are all interwoven with one another in a certain order that makes some sense in terms of the delivery of the material. And it's team taught, but you show up and teach your lectures, and you tend to work with the other people to understand what they're teaching at the same time that you're teaching. You try and develop common problems, common homework problems that stress more than one discipline, so that you can look at some of the interrelationships and trade-offs between the different disciplines.
Okay, so what do students do in class? Is it primarily lecture, or do they work in groups on projects? Or
yeah, the classes are lecture-based, but we have adopted a lot of active learning strategies, and we've done that for the last several years. There are two techniques that we use predominantly. One we call the personal response system, PRS. It's a commercially available product. It's a small television clicker. I've got one here someplace. So this is the television clicker. And typically in a lecture there will be one or two questions that are asked, sometimes three or four. And the students respond to these with these television clickers. And in real time in the class we get the responses back, and we can look at graphs of their responses. So it's a short, you know, 5 or 10 minute lecture with a question, another short 5 or 10 minute lecture, another question, and that allows you in real time to understand what they're having difficulty with and what things they've made progress on understanding, and adjust your lecture as you go. That's the primary in-class technique for engaging the students. We don't grade them on whether or not they get the right response. We just grade them on whether or not they've hit the button. So as part of the subject grade, there's an attendance score, which is calculated by how many times they've pressed the button out of the total number of questions that are asked. And as I said, it's two or three per lecture. The second thing that we do for each lecture is at the end, we finish the lectures a few minutes early, and we ask the students to fill out the muddiest part of the lecture cards. So here's some from my lecture today, where we ask them to take 2 or 3 minutes and reflect on the items that were discussed in lecture and which part was the least clear, so the muddiest part of the lecture. And these are terrific. With these, you can find out in an anonymous way, in the students' own words, which things they found to work and which things that they found to be difficult. And often, you find that items that are tripping them up are the symbols that you used, or that there's some they have some lack of understanding, or some deficiency in remembering some prerequisite subject material that you would presume that they had. And getting this after each lecture, then you can take action on these either by modifying your next lecture, or what I do is respond to them all on the subject webpage. So I just write short answers for each of the questions, and the students can go and look at that. So those are the two techniques that we use within the lectures for better feedback and for active learning. also a series of laboratory exercises and systems problems, but I presume that you'll get an interview with Charles Coleman or something to talk about that aspect of the course.
But you can say that there are laboratory assignments as well, and there are other special elements, there are field trips and things for this class?
Yes, there are a variety of special elements for Unified as a whole. For the lectures that I teach, one of the things that I do is wheel in an engine and teach in front of the engine, and it's a real engine. It's a CFM56, which powers 737 Boeing 737 airplanes. And when you're talking about propulsion, having a couple million dollars worth of hardware there to point to and shake and have the students ask questions about is very, very helpful. So there are elements like that. There are a lot of in-class small demonstrations that each of us do where we ask people to work problems where they estimate things or small in-class experiments. All of those are in the context of these concept questions, or many of them are, where we ask the students to observe an experiment, to think about it, and to respond to some question, all intended to demonstrate physical principles or to get them to think about concepts in the class.
Well, we want to thank you very much for making your materials available through MIT OpenCourseWare. Is there anything else you can think of that you'd like someone to know about how Unified is taught, or anything else that might not be obvious from just viewing the course materials online?
No, I would just say that it is very important to us in developing and delivering the course materials that it be viewed by the students in an integrated way as a package, so that none of the sets of materials were developed as independent pieces on thermodynamics or fluids, but they were developed within the context of it being an integrated course. And we think that's very important for educating students in aeronautics and astronautics, that they do have this integrated system-level view of how the pieces fit together. And we prefer to start that early by doing it all at once early in their careers, and then have them take disciplinary specialties later on rather than vice versa. So that's the only thing that I would point out about it, that it really has been developed to be an integrative learning environment.
So. Okay. Well, thank you very much for your time.
Pleasure.